Hello there, and welcome to Never Mind the Buzzcocks. I'm Simon Amstell, and if you think I'm a poor booking, let's meet tonight's guests. Phil's first guest plays keyboards with cool dude indie band The Delays. It's Aaron Gilbert. The Delays were once caught in the path of a hurricane while they were touring New Orleans. Fortunately, they escaped with just a few cuts and bruises, a widescreen TV, a trombone, and Fats Domino's wheelchair. His second guest is TV presenter and DIY vigilante Nick Knowles. Nick has appeared on DIY SOS, UK's Worst Builder, and Celebrity Fame Academy, where he wore a kilt, prompting the traditional question, who's that twat in the kilt? Nick and Aaron, Bill's team, ladies and gentlemen. Bill's first guest was formerly in prolific, pubescent, power pop pioneers, Blazing Squad. Now with new band, Friday Hill, it's Kenzie. When Kenzie's ex, Jodie Marsh, was asked if he had a schoolboy willy, she said, no, of course he hasn't. It's an adult willy. It's a man's willy all the way. Sadly, the answer was D, and she slipped back down to £32,000. Phil's second guest is a bright young thing on the comedy circuit. It's Russell Howard. Last year, Russell came second in Zoo Magazine's Funniest Comedians poll. He was just beaten by a pissed-up monkey wearing Abby Titmuss's bra, beating a pensioner to death with a kebab. Russell and Kenzie, Phil's team, ladies and gentlemen. We start tonight with connections. Bill, Aaron and Nick, here are your two. She's so lucky, she's a star, but she cries, cries, cries when I interview her. It's Britney Spears. My mum's favourite singer, after Whitney Houston, Aretha Franklin, Dionne Warwick, Toni Braxton, Beverly Knight, Michelle Gale, and that one over M People. It's Tina Turner. Who needs a heart when a heart can be broken? So, that was Britney Spears and Tina Turner, but what connects them, Bill?
Ah, right. There is some kind of tenuous connection, is there?
It's me that hasn't done this before.
Ah.
She looks right there, actually, isn't that? That's the first time I've ever seen Britney Spears looking attractive.
What, you crying?
Yeah. You made her cry, didn't you?
How did you do that then? You said Santa Claus didn't exist or something. Well, how did you...
I just suggested that she might have gone a bit nuts recently, and she took that personally.
She's doing that old Kabbalah thing, isn't she?
Britney?
Yeah. By which you have to wear a red string around your wrist.
Yeah.
Well, not the toughest religion in the world when you think about it, is it?
A bit fiddly, though.
Yeah.
A bit fiddly.
Yeah. Trying to do it up. Yeah. If you can do it up on your own, you've moved to the next level, apparently. That's just... Let's have a look at Tina.
Tina,
walking down the street there. See, this bloke on the right, I reckon he's got his hand up a cow.
It's a street.
Just out of shot. He's like a Brooklyn urban street vet. Yo, I fix a cow while I'm just chilling.
I'll be honest, that's quite a tall cow when you look at the fella.
No, it's on a box. It's on a box, yeah.
Could the connection be that Tina Turner was a hod carrier and Britney Spears' house is made out of bricks?
That's correct. Let's move on.
Yes.
It could be rhyming.
Britney, oh, you mean rhyming slang? Britney Spears, shears.
Tina Turner,
industrial burner.
But if that was the way, James Blunt would be in real trouble.
Yeah, well. I think they've got things named after them. They've got a brand of jam named after them. I'm guessing now.
Both the kids are good at stuff.
That's nailed it down for us.
Yeah. One of them must have been the answer.
I can see now why Mark gets angry all the time. It sort of makes sense. Shall I tell you the answer?
Yes, please.
The answer is that both singers' music has been used to frighten off wild animals.
How are we supposed to get that? Where was that published?
You need to work a bit harder, Enrique.
I've lost interest. Why, you're ridiculous, guy.
Can be your hero, baby.
Oh,
quite like you, Nick. My mum actually said she quite fancies you.
Was it?
She said, you've got a lovely big face. Britney Spears CDs are used by German farmers to keep wild boar from eating their crops. Meanwhile, Tina Turner's greatest hits are used at Gloucestershire Airport to scare birds from the runway. They originally tried Ronan Keating's album, but the birds kept hurling themselves into jet engines. At the 2003 MTV Awards, Britney shared a kiss with Christina Aguilera and Madonna, but the whole stunt backfired when Madonna got a hard on. When Tina's ex-husband Ike Turner was sent to prison, he was so scared of being held with the other prisoners that he got himself transferred to the hospital wing. And oh, sorry, I'll start that one again.
No, it went very well, I thought.
Thank you very much. Why can't I be a pro like Knowles? It could be worse. I could be Kate Thornton. When Tina's ex-husband returns after the break. Bill Russell and Kenzie, these are for you. Red summer sky is bright, your smile I could never hide, your golden gaze. He seems like a nice bloke, but if he doesn't get the aisle seat, he might chop off your hands, the cheeky monkey. It's Ian Brown. Your golden gaze. So wet, they name them thrice. It's the best thing since sliced perineum, wet, wet, wet. So that was Ian Brown and Wet, 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 but what connects the two?
This is the same wet, wet, wet as Love Is All Around Me, wet, wet, wet.
Yeah.
What?
17 weeks at number one, a third of the year.
Oh, f***ing hell.
Ah, the wisdom of youth.
How young are you?
I've just turned 20.
Okay. Kenzie's sweet, isn't he? Isn't Kenzie sweet? Yeah. Why don't you tell the nice BBC viewers what your song Flip Reverse It was all about?
Women.
Women. Women, yes.
It was about anal in a truck. Offended by 17 weeks for the idea of bombing a lady in a Mazda. Fine.
The youth for today, it's not my fault. What? How do you see flip reversing? Because I might see it in a different light to you.
Okay, well, you tell me how you see it.
No, you go first. No, you go first.
I just interpreted the song.
I see it about kind of stopping what you're doing, turning it around and going back again. It doesn't have to mean sex. That's not about sex, that could be about life in general.
It yeah. Could be a driving test, couldn't it?
You've got to see the bigger picture. Now, I want to explain this just to cover up, because I've got quite a young fan base as well.
Yeah.
And, you can't put me on the spot like that.
You wrote a song about bumming.
My mum's going to watch this.
Your mum's going to watch it?
No, yeah.
Now, why is that relevant, Ken?
Well, because I don't want her to think her son's like that.
Okay.
I've got a girlfriend at the moment. What's she going to think of this?
I don't know. Can she sit?
Well, good. I think we've covered anal sex there.
Cool.
This is on the screen here. It's how you imagine Darth Vader's sperm would look.
Great. That looks like Blazing Squad.
Is that what they're doing now? Because you've all broken up now.
Where's Strider?
What are they all doing? Strider made it.
Did he escape to the outside?
We're going by.
Escape from Blazing Squad. Yeah.
We're going by.
He gnawed his way through a hutch.
We're going by our human names to be taken more seriously.
Ah. Your human names. Well, I think that's worked, Kenzie.
There's four of them are starting the Blazing Squad again.
All right, that'll be successful for them.
Yeah, one of them's gone solo, and two of them have gone out and got jobs.
Oh, what did they do? It says on your CV here, you're in Blazing Squad. Tell me a little about that.
Yeah, we busted it large. And we did it on the flip side.
Hey, let's have a look at Wet, Wet, Wet here. Look at that.
Yeah, that doesn't look good, does it?
No, no, it's wrong.
Oh. All those elephants in the sea with erections.
And then here.
That looks like a Hare Krishna suicide, doesn't it? Or like a 1980s version of Lost. I'm going to tambourine my way off the island.
Has Kinsey crept up with his anal sex record just behind Mr. Brown there?
The answer is, both have sponsored football teams. Ian Brown has recently thrown his support behind non-league Chiswick Homefields, and at the height of their fame, Wet 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 sponsored their boyhood idols, Clydebank. Marty Pello was so dedicated that after every game, he would collect the shirts, tie them tightly around his arm, and applaud. Is that right? Did I get that right, Kenzie? I don't know what I...
I don't do it! Don't do me, I do anal sex.
Next up is the intros round. Bill and Aaron, here are yours for Nick.
Oh, no.
I didn't like that. Let's try that again.
Let's do it more nonchalant. I'll pretend like we're talking about something, and you laugh like we're in a play.
Yeah.
All right, let's try again.
Bill!
Good luck, Nick. Thanks very much.
Really?
I know your mum's rooting for me. And my big face.
Yeah. Yeah. She's watching you on widescreen.
Yeah. So... Is it going to develop at all?
No,
that's it.
It's going to repeat some more the same.
Is it something by the Streets? Was it something by
How cool
Queen?
Are you trying to sound there? Was it something by the Streets?
Honestly, it sounds like a ringtone gone wrong to me. I haven't got a clue.
You don't know. I'm passing it over.
Speed of Sound.
Speed of Sound. That's Let's right. hear it.
I can see that now.
You can use it now.
Yeah.
Should I give you a point for seeing it now?
Would help. Because they just got a point.
They got a point.
Yes.
So we can equalise by me recognising it afterwards. This could work very well for us.
Hang on. I've lost control of the whole thing. I feel like I'm the supply teacher and you're not... You're just not respecting me as you should.
Play the track and I'll see if I can guess which one of them is going to take the lead and which one's going to do the job.
How about you be quiet and stop throwing chalk knolls? It's your own time you're wasting.
Ding
ding ding ding ding
ding ding ding ding ding
ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding ding.
Are you remembering of a particularly bad bit of guttering from 1987?
I just thought I might get one of these, you know what I mean? You sit there and watch the programme and you think, oh, I could do that, and you sort of shout at the screen. And now I feel like a tit.
Did any of you look, Kevin?
Yeah.
They got them. That's 2 points to the audience, which means they're in the lead.
Stop interfering. Stop interfering with the points.
Forget I spoke.
OK. Always do. So that was The Bad Touch by the Bloodhound Gang. The Bloodhound Gang recruited one of their band members from a local supermarket, which is quite the opposite of Netto's policy, who recruit most of their staff from Atomic Kitten. We also heard Speed of Sound by Coldplay. It can be quite hard to make fun of Chris Martin. He just seems to be such a good bloke, making nice music and doing a lot of work for charity. Nick here does a lot of charity work too, but only to get on TV.
What are you doing? Bothered face.
Why?
Okay, Phil and Kenzie, These are yours for Russell.
That's next.
Good luck, Russell.
Thank you.
Oh, he started. He's freestyling already. He loves it. Loves it. I imagine when Kenzie started singing then, the ears of the other members of the squad just pricked up around the land. Like funky meerkats. Kenzie's in trouble, put that mouse down! I've no idea, but then towards the end of the song, Kenzie started doing that. Which I
was running out of oxygen.
No, I thought you were pointing at yourself. So is it flip reverse by the squad?
No.
Why don't we do that though?
Oh.
Do you want to do it?
Yeah, come on. No. Then you go. Oh, I'm gonna flip reverse you.
What, like Mr. Bumble from Charles Dickens?
Sing!
No. I'm not a singer. Where have you got this fixed? I can't sing. I rap.
You rap?
Oh, no.
Any idea? I've forgotten the song. I've no idea. No idea.
I'm going to pass it over.
Okay.
Any ideas?
Was it Paula Abdul?
Go on.
I don't know the track title yet.
How did you know it was Paula Abdul?
From that funky bass line.
Yeah.
You should have seen my feet at it under the table.
Okay, you know it's Paula Abdul.
I can't remember the name.
It was Straight Up by Paula Abdul.
It was.
Yeah. Let's see how it should have sounded. Funky.
Right on.
Have you met Paula Abdul?
No, I'll tell you what I've met.
Who have you met?
No one.
Come on, who
do
you met?
We'll talk after.
Let's talk now!
it's the answer. I didn't...
I think you better
get away and ruin the game.
Have you really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Right, you ready?
Yeah.
Janow, janow, gling, gling.
Oh, I really should know this as well, shouldn't I? I feel like the kid who wasn't allowed real instruments at school. Kumbaya, my lord. Oh, Carolina by Shaggy. I've got no idea.
I'm going to pass it over.
Was it Bat Out of Hell by Meatloaf?
Yeah.
Correct. This is what it would have sounded like.
When did you meet Meatloaf?
We were doing Party in the Park in 2002 with the squad, and he walked past us.
Wow. I would have saved that story for Parky, personally.
Yo, Parky.
Yeah.
Do I talk like that?
Do you talk like what?
Like they're kind of saying. Like this
no,
kind
of course you
like
don't.
Like Ali G. I listen to my. I don't watch myself or listen to it because I do find it quite painful. But when I do get a glimpse, when I catch a glimpse, I don't talk like that. I'm pretty sure, as a youth, maybe I'm 20 now. I'm a man
with a man's willy, people.
I think someone. You think you should cut me a bit of slack?
Yes. Can we all stop taking the Mickey out of Kenzie?
No.
Yeah.
He is my friend from Pop World. Only I can call him a moron. Okay. So, that was Bat Out of Hell by Meatloaf. Meatloaf once said frigging on Channel 4 breakfast show Rise. That day there were thousands of complaints. This programme, shit. When's Meatloaf coming on? We also heard Straight Up by Paula Abdul. During the last series of American Idol, there was. There were...
Scurrilous.
Scurrilous, thank you very much.
Just trying to help.
Ooh, I can read!
One of them had to.
Yeah.
Toilets this way, guys!
During the last series of American Idol, there were scurrilous rumours in the US that Paula Abdul secretly fancied fellow judge Simon Cowell. So, she's a tit woman. Round three is the identity parade. Bill, Aaron and Nick, we've got some glam superstars for you. For the audience only, here's Wizard with See My Baby Jive. Wizard hitting the top spot with See My Baby Jive back in 1973. But can you guess which of our lineup is saxophone player Mike Burney? Is it number one, Baby Jive? Number two, Baby Wipes? Number three, Baby Aubergine? Number four, Baby Jesus? Or number five, Baby Killer?
Number five looks not, I don't know, of this world. number two has got a look about him. I am the director of this facility, and you're very welcome to see the secure unit. Number four's got slightly, I don't know, a kind of a swagger.
What's wrong with his mouth? Number four, keep your mouth still. Number four, stop chewing. Stop it. But it, just close. No, what are you doing? Number four, just keep it closed. Bill, he won't stop chewing. Please, somebody, is he having some sort of fit? Stop teasing me. Either just keep your mouth shut or take your teeth out. Don't keep playing with everything.
No, it's the effects of ecstasy.
Yeah.
Number four's expression hasn't changed in minutes.
That's a mask.
Is it?
The thing he's going to pull it off me is Tom Cruise.
He looks ever so smart, doesn't he, number five, in his sequins?
Yeah, actually, yeah, that's, he's more glam than the rest of them. A glam security guard. no, I reckon number three.
You're going for three?
Go on, three.
OK. Will the real Mike Burney please step forward?
Yeah.
Number three. Now performing with his own band, the Mike Burney Jazz Quartet. Mike Burney, ladies and gentlemen. OK, Phil, Russell and Kenzie, we've got some rock action for you. For the audience only, here's a group of nice young men from Birmingham called Napalm Death. How lovely. That was Napalm Death with Scum. But which of our lineup is former lead singer Lee Dorian? Is it number one? Number two? Number three? Number four? Or number five? Any ideas, gentlemen?
Napalm Death.
Yeah.
It's a bit full on. Number one, two, or five?
One. Well, narrow down, Kens. Number four looks like he's got a lot going on in his shed.
In what sense?
Oh, he's just got lots of bric-a-brac, you know. A soda stream next to a gimp mask, that kind of stuff.
Sometimes go by shoes.
Number five's boots are quite impressive, if you like treading on people's faces.
I should think you're in line for a little visit.
They all look like they'd be great uncles.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come in my shed and I've got some porn and some dope.
I think number five has probably got an eighth on him right now.
I don't know what he means, do you, Kenzie?
Yeah.
No.
I think it's number one. I really think it's number one.
I think one as well. I'm with you on one.
OK, you're going with one.
Yes.
Let's please. See if you're right with the real Lee. Please make himself known.
Please.
There you go. He's playing with his new doom metal band, Cathedral, and running his own record label, Lee Dorian, ladies and gentlemen. Right, so we end with next lines. Bill's team are in the lead, so they go first.
Yes.
Your time starts now. Nobody does it better.
Nobody does it half as good as you?
Right? No.
Makes me feel sad for the rest.
I guess I could accept that.
Surely, why not?
Don't put yourself
right.
out, you know.
Correct, Carly Simon.
Thank you.
I can see a hurricane tonight.
It keeps me from my Valentine.
Correct, the delays.
Hey.
You and me, baby, we ain't nothing but mammals.
Let's do it like we do on the Discovery Channel.
Correct, Bloodhound Gang. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Come on, Nick. This is your area.
I don't know.
Yes, we can.
It's Bob the Builder, yes, we can.
Oh, bucks.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more.
Ain't got time to fix the windows, ain't got time to fix the doors.
Close, but not quite there. Surely this must have been a theme tune on one of your shows at some point.
You'd think, wouldn't you?
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Hello, I'm Nick Knowles. Ain't got time to fix the shingles, ain't got time to fix the floor.
Ain't got time to fix the shingles? Surely that's an unpleasant skin disease. Why?
In my dear city hospital.
Oh,
as well,
of course. So. Right.
OK. You need 8 to win. Your time begins now. I'm Luke, I'm 5, and my dad's Bruce Lee.
He drives me around in his JCB.
Correct. And his Lopey on his Loppy.
His Lopey. Don't matter, does it?
His Lopey.
Yeah.
Bonus point.
Thank you. Oh, it does matter.
Look in your eyes, I see a new story.
I can't deny my past ain't perfect too.
Correct, Friday Hill.
Cool.
We always hang in a buffalo stance.
It's what we do every time we dance.
But what is it that you do?
Hang in a buffalo stance. You've already clarified that.
We do the dive every time we dance. Every little thing that you say or do, I'm hung up.
I've had enough of you.
No.
I've hanging up on you.
No.
I'm waiting for you.
No. Hung up
sorry.
On you.
Of course it don't.
I said that.
You said I'm hanging up on you.
Oh, come on.
You did, yeah. Well, I imagine you all want to know what the final scores are. Phil's team have 7. Bill's team have 10. So, thanks to Bill, Aaron and Nick, Phil, Russell and Kenzie, this has been Nevermind the Buzzcocks. I've been Simon Amstel. And before I go back to youth television, bollocks. Good night. Well, coming up now.